Thank you. It's not Good morning, everyone. Good morning. We certainly were blessed with a great day here today. Our first student taking the stage is Lisa Rosales. Lisa is a four-year AVID student, and she is currently employed at Cuco's Restaurant in Cary, Illinois. When I asked Mrs. Bowman about Lisa, she told me that Lisa often describes herself as an incredibly shy person. In looking back over the years, she shared several times when Lisa would hide behind the podium and dread speaking in front of people. Yet in just a few moments, Lisa will be speaking in front of this crowd here today. And she will be sharing with us the Pledge of Allegiance. And how fitting, because Lisa has made the decision to serve our country by enlisting in the United States Marine Corps Reserve. With plans to later transfer to the University of Illinois Urbana-Champaign. Mrs. Bowman shared that Lisa is strong, resilient, and independent. She meets challenges and adversity with a determination and generous spirit. She also leads by example and constantly strives to be better, both of which will undoubtedly serve her well in her future endeavors, particularly as a United States Marine. Lisa's future is so incredibly bright, and I am overjoyed that she has finally found her voice. Please join me in welcoming Lisa Rosales to the stage to lead us in the Pledge of Allegiance, followed by the singing of the National Anthem. Please stand.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Okay, you can please be seated. At this time, it's my honor to recognize a very special student who will be leaving Crystal Lake South today, achieving certificate of completion and moving on to the next part of his life. Please give a round of applause to Aaron Jacobs.
band and choir, you can go ahead and move this time. The next student joining us on stage is a member of the CLS Theater, CLS Choir, French Honor Society, and was an officer in National Honor Society her senior year. The student will be attending the University of Iowa next fall. When I asked Mr. Busom about this young lady, he said, Lauren Rudine came to CLS as a quiet, shy, timid freshman. During her time here, however, Lauren found herself, but perhaps more importantly, she found her voice. The girl who would never raise her hand in class, now a bright, confident young woman, stands before this crowd here today to begin our celebration. Lauren Rudine is truly the embodiment of our District 155 mission. She entered high school with promise, and she leaves here today with purpose. Whether it's dancing across the stage for theater, organizing school events for her peers, or making others smile in the hallways, CLS will miss her empathy, her energy, her kindness, and her curiosity. Mr. Busom also shared, when I see Lauren in the hallways, I think to myself, please, please let my daughter turn out just like her. She truly represents the best in all of us. I'm extraordinarily proud of Lauren, and I can't wait to see what the future has in store for her. At this time, I would like to introduce Lauren Rudine to the stage to welcome everyone to today's graduation ceremony.
Good morning, parents, staff, and students. We've been expecting you. Prior to writing this speech, I really dove into the idea of what a welcome truly is. We experience them multiple times daily. Sometimes they're done well, and sometimes they're not. However, I've been assured that even the worst welcomes can end happily. Why do you think I applied for this speech instead of one of the other two? Regardless, even if I completely butcher this today, we all still receive our diplomas, hopefully. In my preparatory research for this morning, I found a list of three ways to welcome people. The first one is to acknowledge that you've been expecting them. Check. The second is to provide them with a tour of wherever you are welcoming them to. So, to the right, we have the visitor bleachers. Since I can remember, they've always been the visitors until that one year when they grew in confidence and became the home bleachers. But now, as you can see, they have shrunk and once again house the opposing teams. Behind me, we've got the end zone. Some pretty great points have been earned there. Finally, about 100 yards down, we've got yet another end zone. And yes, that is the same one where one of our very own linemen scored a touchdown this football season. And finally, according to the list, the third tip in welcoming people is to ask for their feedback. How am I doing? A hotel executive once said, in any hospitality environment, the spirit of welcome is so important in creating a strong foundation for the guest experience. While I may not be delivering the senior address or even presenting you with the final remarks of your high school career, my task in welcoming you is less about what I get to say and more about how I do it. Much like this speech, high school seemed to come and go in an instant. I want you to think back to your first day walking through the doors of Crystal Lake South. While many of you may not be able to remember the details of that day, much like many of you won't remember anything I mutter in the next few minutes, I guarantee that on that day, each and every one of you were welcomed here in some way. A welcome is something that requires two parties, those doing the welcoming and those being welcomed, both of whom are often reversed. Much like how I, along with all of my peers, was once welcomed to the school as a freshman, I stand here welcoming all of you to the ceremony. A welcome is so much more than words spoken at the beginning of something. It is meant to assure the guests that where they are is where they have been invited to be, and encourage their decision to stay and enjoy the environment they have become a part of. Today, however, will not be the last of your welcomes. In fact, as you leave here today, you'll be moving on to a whole new life that's bound to be full of exciting, fresh beginnings. Not only will you be given the chance to try out those three tips I shared earlier, but you will be exposed to bigger and better things than you could have ever imagined. That is why it is my honor to welcome you to the 2018-2019 Crystal Lake South graduation ceremony. Congratulations, Gators, and good luck. Your future is expecting you. Thank you.
At this time, the senior band members will lead us in their final instrumental presentation by performing Vulcan by Michael Doherty, conducted by Mr. Cody Helberstadt. Great job, band. I would now like to invite our senior choir members to join us in singing their final song, This Is Me, arranged by Benj Pasek and Justin Paul, conducted by Mr. Stuart Buto. Let's hear it one more time for both the band and choir. The next speaker joining us on stage is a man heavily involved in the fine arts here at Crystal Lake South. He participated in 4 years of choir, including 2 years as a member of the Madrigal Ensemble. He has also been very involved in student leadership and has been a member of our theater program for the last 4 years. When I asked Mr. Stoner about Aaron Fader, he shared that he has had the privilege of getting to know many great students over the years. But when one the caliber of Aaron Fader walks through our doors, attention must be paid. Since his freshman year, Aaron has been a leader in every possible way, whether it was asked of him or not. Through countless hours of rehearsals, classes, tech builds, and meetings, Mr. Stoner has watched this enthusiastic and kind young man impact the people, productions, and programs around him. As comfortable with adults as he is with peers, he harnesses so many incredible qualities that his intellect is an afterthought. His compassion, his sense of humor, his courtesy, his charisma, his integrity and his consideration for others are virtually unparalleled. Through good times or challenges, he invests mightily in his community, always making it stronger for his involvement. His contribution to CLS is immeasurable, and we feel blessed to have had a front row seat to witness this chapter of his journey. Please let's welcome Aaron Fader to the stage for this year's senior address.
Some are born great, some achieve greatness, and some have greatness thrust upon them. Here at Crystal Lake South, we've seen a bit of it all. Some came into their first year ready to take off and challenge themselves. They were born great. Others took some warming up to the idea of a new and somewhat daunting challenge. They achieved greatness. Others are extremely happy that this day is here and that the struggle is over. They had greatness thrust upon them. Some were passionate about school, and others needed a spark fanned into a flame. It doesn't matter how you arrived here. What matters is that you did it. Congratulations. But before we talk about us, let's remember that we wouldn't be here today if it weren't for all the love and support that we've received over the years from our faculty and above all our families. So thank you, all of you. It's really strange to be in front of you all today. Just a year ago, we still had our valedictorian and our salutatorian speak to us, in which case I most definitely would not be speaking up here today. But here I am and here you are, right as rain. Now, over the course of our 4 years, we've spent time cramming for tests, scoring 2-for-1s in the vending machine, sprinting across school in hopes of an open gym volleyball spot, and tightening our backpack straps and hauling to class upon hearing the musical 3 Seconds. Some of us played in our last game, some of us took our last bow, and some of us had our last competition. But you see, we all found ourselves in high school. Whether it was a group of friends, an activity, sport, or club, we found a home to keep us safe over the course of those long, grueling years. And now it's time to say thank you and goodbye. But this was just the beginning of us. We have so much more to look forward to. You see, each of us have planned for a future that only we could desire, whether that be a 4- or 2-year college, the workforce, or the military. We have made our choice because that's what we're passionate about. And don't ever let anyone take that away from you. I mean, maybe at one point or another you conform to a group because you were more comfortable doing so. Not really sure why. It's not like high school's cliquey or anything. Whether you did that or not is besides the point. Just leave that behind. Now, if you've tuned out, this is the important part, so listen closely. What you're doing after today is your future, and it's your job to maintain it, tend to it, and above all, lead it. The only thing stopping you is you. So find your passion. Invest yourself. Let it motivate you. Let it shine through you and onto others. Thank you. Congratulations, class of 2019. Go break some eggs.
Let's give one more round of applause for each of our 3 speakers already here this morning. My turn. Good morning again, students, and good morning to all of the parents, siblings, grandparents, aunts, and uncles who are joining us here today. Whether you walked here from just down the street or you flew in from across the country, it is great to have you here celebrating with us at Crystal Lake South High School. We all have a lot to be proud of as we look out over our graduates. They have accomplished a lot and are ready for the next stage of their journey. Before I begin, I'd like to welcome a few people who are sitting beside me here on stage. I'd like to welcome Adam Guss, school board member. I'd like Nicole Pavoris, school board member. And Steve Olson, superintendent of District 155. I'd also like to welcome all of our faculty and administration who have joined us here today. Thank you to each of you for supporting our students as they entered our doors 4 short years ago and as they are walking out of them here today. Could I please ask each of you as staff to stand and be recognized? We have a few staff members in attendance this morning who will be starting the next portion of their journey in retirement. I would ask that Ann Burns, Susan Diodar, Gus Serio, Jan Blum, and Joe Cole stand to be recognized for their years of service to the students of Crystal Lake South High School. I have a few additional thank yous. I'd like to extend a thank you to our Booster Club and to the Barn Nursery. All of your work this morning and all the decorations out here really look great. So thank you to each of our Booster Club members who were here this morning helping us with that setup. I'd like to thank my secretary, Stacy Faber, and all of our senior class sponsors for all of the organization and planning that went into making today a possibility. And lastly, I'd like to thank the maintenance and custodial staff for being here early this morning, taking care of all of our setup, and for all of your work over the last 2 days, making sure that this stage was ready to go. I would like to take a moment to recognize those students who are pursuing career paths in the military. Students, as I say your name, please stand and be recognized. Caleb Barnabold, Air Force. Anthony Cabrera, Navy. Bennett Carr, Marines. David Eckloff, Navy. Milton Irvin, Army. Maria Garcia, Army. Noah Johnson, Marines. Will Lawrence, Navy. Ishmael Larios, Navy. Jacob Marchek, National Guard. Tad Mears, Navy. Alec Natrop, Navy. Armando Palomar, National Guard. Jesus Rodriguez, Marines. Lisa Rosales, Marines. Jacob Trinidad, Marines. Shane Wershing, Navy. And Carson Zorza, National Guard. Let's hear one more round of applause for all of these students. So the class of 2019 here today has accomplished a ton in terms of numbers over their four-year career. Today I would like to highlight a few of the numbers associated with this great group of students. The class of 2019 has earned over $2 million in scholarship, of which $69,000 was in local community scholarships. The class of 2019 has our highest ever SAT score, and they have taken more AP tests than any class before them. This class has 71 Illinois State Scholars. They have 18 students pursuing military service. They have 12 students who participated this year in a career internship during their senior year. They have 8 AVID graduates, 7 National Merit recognized students. They have 6 National Merit semifinalists, 5 National Merit finalists, which is an all-time high at Crystal Lake South, and they have 2 perfect 36 ACT scores. This group as a class, they have survived the adjustment of the musical minutes to the musical 15 seconds, or as Aaron just noted, the musical 3 seconds. And you're the only senior class in CLS history that I believe will be able to say that you were invited to Jeremy's baby shower. Beyond these numbers, this class also has accomplished the following. This is a pretty long list. This class has our first boys basketball conference championship since 1993-94. Our first girls outright softball conference championship since the spring of 1986. Our first girls cross country state qualifying team in school history. Our first ever best choreography nomination by the Illinois High School Musical Theater Awards. This class has also seen students as state qualifiers or state champs in the following areas. Again, another long list here. Boys golf, boys cross country, girls tennis, band, choir, theater, the Academic Challenge Team, Bass Fishing, Family, Career, and Community Leaders of America, FCCLA, Baseball, Boys Track, Math Team, Girls Gymnastics, Boys Swimming, and the Dance Team. And if by chance you somehow missed it earlier this year, one state championship boys soccer team. But beyond the numbers, the class of 2019 is filled with the genuine people who are prepared academically and emotionally to tackle the challenges ahead. We regularly talk about the characteristics of being a Gator, the characteristics of growth, acceptance, tenacity, optimism, and responsibility. As a class, you have demonstrated those characteristics and have found a great deal of success over the last 4 years. I have confidence that as you travel to new places and that as you find yourself in new situations in life, it is these characteristics that will continue to define you and help you achieve your successes. I end my graduation speech today with a very short story and a simple one at that. And it brings me back to my teenage years. At your age, I was very involved in athletics and would regularly attend athletic camps throughout the summer. One particular camp that I would attend each year was called Jeff Trickey's Quarterback Camp. And this particular camp was my favorite camp and the one that I attended year after year. Jeff Trickey was the founder of this program, and he would end each camp with the same story and the same message. He would pull a picture frame out of a duffel bag, and in that frame would be a picture of himself back in high school. He would show us the picture and tell us a story about himself at that very age. He would then flip the frame over and take the back off the picture frame and show us another picture of himself on the inside. That picture was a picture of himself as a child, say maybe 8 or 9 years old. He would then share with us the moral of his story. Be the teenager your 8 or 9 year old self would be proud of. That story has always stuck with me, and as a result, I have a picture on my desk of my son peeking over my wife's shoulder as a reminder to me of the importance of making decisions each day that my 8 or 9 year old son would be proud of. Students, my challenge for you today is for you to do the same at this stage of your journey, a stage that is going to see many changes in the coming months and the years ahead. That same stage that is going to see you develop from a teenager here today into an adult in the years ahead. I would ask that you find a picture of yourself from today, a picture of yourself from the age of 8 or 9, and put them back to back in a picture frame. And then reflect on those pictures over the years ahead to ensure that your decisions are the decisions that have that would have made you proud during your younger years. Class of 2019, we are so proud of what you have already accomplished, and we wish you the best of luck in the years ahead. Congratulations, class of 2019. At this time, I would welcome Community High School District 155 School Board Member Nicole Pavoris to the podium.
Good morning, everyone. And on behalf of the District 155 Board of Education, congratulations, class of 2019. I am excited to be here to celebrate this milestone with you and to wish you well on your new beginning. As you may know, while graduation is considered an end of a student's school journey, it is really just the beginning. Commencement means a beginning or start of something. In your case, that's life after high school. While I'm pretty sure that you will not remember what I say here today, I would like to tell you two things. Always work hard and don't give up. Both of these values have brought you to this accomplishment at this moment and will carry you wherever you want to go. Think about all of the work that you, the class of 2019, have put in to getting here. Some of you left it all on the field, to bring a state soccer championship home to Gator Nation. Some of you honed your leadership skills with Captain's Council. Some of you even got to explore new cultures and take in amazing sights around the world. Some of you brought down the house with incredible musical and theatrical performances. Some of you learned how to take copious Cornell notes, which helped you get here today. Some of you introduced us to the future with innovative robots. Some made the world more beautiful with their works of art. Some of you have made friendships that will last a lifetime. But all of you have worked hard to get here, and you should be proud. Realistically, however, hard work is only one aspect of what has brought you here today. The other part is your perseverance, determination, and tenacity. In other words, you learn to not give up. For as many successes that I have just named, you may have experienced just as many setbacks, but you kept going. You didn't give up, and that's what matters. Keep that spirit with you as you move forward in your journey, no matter what path you are taking, because whether you are off to college, the military, or the workforce, there will be stumbles along the way. But use what you learned here at South to pick yourself up, dust yourself off, and keep going. You can do it. You are sitting here getting ready to graduate due to your hard work and you not giving up. Congratulations again. Thank you.
At this time, we'll be recognizing each student in the class of 2019 with their diploma.
Claire K. Alfonso, Yusra Ali, Janessa Camille Allen, Bardia Amin, Jacob Edward Amoroso, Greer A. Anderson, Michaela Cheyenne Anderson, Nathan William Odette, Emily Quinn Banasiak, Alan J. Barnett, Cameron Lee Louise Barnett, Caleb Michael Barnaval, Alexandra Lynn Barrett, Daniel Andrew Basil, Ian Robert Beatty, Angela Kristen Becker, Jack Robert Becker, Olivia Y. Beckwith, Caitlin N. Bukowski, Dana Morgan Bell, Kate Bellman, Logan Abraham Bendel, Nicolette J. Benoit, Emily Caitlin Burnaby, Daniela Bernal, Hannah E. Biba, Dominic A. Bogach, Brooke E. Bolin. Zachary J. Borgert. Ilianis Borges. Jordan Lee Borkren. Vishal Brahmbhatt. Eric J. Bregenzer. Gavin W. Bright. Jillian Page Brokoff. Jacob Joe Brown. Lily Ann Brown. Cassandra Genoveva Bueno. Bailey David Burkhart. Madeline Marie Bush. Carson Keith Butkus. Robert Mariano Caballero. Anthony J. Cabrera. Sean Camp. Joshua M. Campion. Bennett A. Carr. Cameron Peter Castro. Connor Jerome Castro. Megan Rose Seraldi. Alexander Fergus Sergek. Riddy Davy Chingacom. Jacob Michael Civarella. Emma J. Classeri. Griffin Michael Coakley. Alexander Giuliano Colangelo. Janae Nicole Conklin. Ryan G. Cook. Hannah N. Corcoran. Ryan William Coughlin. Richard John Cristanti. Abigail Elizabeth Cronin. Nayeli Cruz Leva. Alexander Anton Senar. Victor Sergey Curry. Tiffany Ann Dabrowski. Devin J. Dawson. James Tyler Day. Shane Deacon. Jacob Ronald De La Rosa. Ryan William De La Rosa. Saverio James De Rosa. Nia Maya Christine Donka. Evan Joseph Downing. Isabel Marie Doyle. Claire Elizabeth Duffy. Justin James Duncan. Brooke Taylor Dunteman. Trevor David Ducks. David Alexander Eckloff. Andrew Michael Edge. Timothy Gerald Eilert. Mallory Nicole Ellers. William G. Epperson. Milton Irvin. Oscar Estrada. Olivia Rose Farley. Aaron David Fader. Patrick Michael Fisher. Hannah Lee Fisher. Devaney Lynn Flagg. Luke Dunham Fulmer. Faith Marie Foster.
Grant Charles Feudel. Jacob Michael France. Alex T. Freeman. Alex is not in attendance today because he is competing in the state tennis sectional. Baker Fuentes Reyes. Samuel K. Garby. Maria De Jesus Garcia. Kristen A. Gates. Joseph E. Geenan. Benjamin Neil Geske. Jacob R. Golick. Mason G. Gallahan. Emmanuel Gonzalez. Leslie Guadalupe Gonzalez. Robert R. Gonzalez. Jonathan Gorak. Bradley Grabowski. Liam Bauer Gray. Kaylee Allison Green. Ethan Harris Greenspan. Brenda Esmeralda Guerrero. Katura Michelle Hagerman. Tyler Bryant Hall. Amanda Leanne Hauk. Benjamin D. Hausch. Olivia Lynn Hauser. Michael Robert Helm. Javier Hermosillo. Kyle Hetherington. Emma Jean Hoyk. Keaton B. Hoffman. Samantha B. Hogue. Alyssa Michelle Holtz. Rebecca F. Horvath. Megan Marie House. Casey John Hunter. Nora L. Hunter. Sonia Huck. Mert Emorowski. Justin A. Jagello. Rishab Jane. Gavin R. James. Benjamin Philip Jenkins. Hallie Lynn Jensen. Evan Dale Jusen. Augustus George Johnson. Noah Dallas Johnson. Brendan Russell Jones. Preston Joseph. Brandon J. Josefowitz. Sydney G. Kasser. Alexandra R. Carney. Trevor Ryan Keegan. Daniel David King. Logan Josiah Kirking. Ethan Aaron Kleiner. Lindsay Aaron Klotz. Stephanie Marie Klotz. Jacob T. Kasemba. Nathaniel Coe. Seth W. Kossoff. Alexander Robert Krochek. Matthew Allen Kubitz. Noah Russell Laney. Nicholas J. Langdon. Natalie Rose Languido. Ismail Larios. Paul Jeffrey Larson. Trevor Larson. Daniel H. LaRue. Danielle Patricia Laurie. Julia Angela Lavarada. Colby D. Law. William C. Lawrence. Kate Danielle Lawson. Ryan Anthony Lawson. Christina Angel Lehman. Kaylin Grace Leva. Brent Michael Linning. Justin Gary Little. Nicholas Scott Loesch. Anthony Ronald Levergine. Daniel Cooper Lyons. Tegan S. McNaught. Lucas A. Majira. Victoria Veronica Menkowski. Nicholas Salvatore Manella.
Trent J. Manning. Vincent Anthony Marcel. Jacob Andrew Marchick. Nicholas Francesco Marchese. Seth Garrett Martinez. Haley Elizabeth Matthews. Jacob Matsumoto. Jamie Lee Teresa Mall. Matthew George McCaleb. Caitlin Elena McDougall. Shane Edward McMonagall. Rachel Marie McNamara. Thomas Michael McSweeney. Tad Robert Mears. Samantha F. Meissner. Aaron Matthew Michaels. Daniel M. Minogue is not in attendance today. He is competing in the state tennis sectionals. Dylan J. Miralia. Ryan D. Miralia. Dominic Gregory Mitchell. James Lewis Moore. Ava Marie Moreno. Nicholas James Morrissey. Brandon T. Morse. Madison Nicole Mueller. Serena Marie Milroe. Casey Mutka. Nathan Joseph Myers. Matt Meislek. Ethan David Nabong. Alec Jeffrey Natrope. Zaylene I. Negron. Lindsay R. Newton. Anthony Wynn. Sarah Nichols. Alyssa Megan Nikitopoulos. John William Nomikos. Trent Knorr. Emily Roberta Nowicki. Ty Jacob O'Brien. Trevor James O'Connor. Devin Odell. Harrison Oberman. Gabriella Ochaita. Sora Ogawa. Skylar Cheyenne Olson. Michael Austin Orpin. Natalia Stopka. Haley J. Page. Samuel Walker Palmer. Armando Palomar. Luis A. Pastor. A little faster. Akshat V. Patel. Duruvi Patel. Jill M. Patel. Jason M. Patfield. Megan H. Paulson. Brenda Marie Perez. Natalie Petrowski. Clayton Douglas Pfeiffer. Ryan Charles Page Puckett. Hannah Lynn Pfister. Jacqueline Marie Phillips. Amber Nicole Pope. Michael Kenneth Portuasi. Jacob Gregory Polis. Aspen Alexis Pressois. Alexa Anastasia Prokos. Zoe H. Purcell. Devin Reese Quick. Logan Nicholas Rainey. Nolan M. Rainey. Jacob Lewis Rana. Matthew Edward Rial. Kimberly Hope Reitz. Jared Andrew Reiling. Amelia R. Ryder. Mackenzie Lily Reeder. Vanessa E. Rhodes. Monet D. Riddle. Maggie Kathleen Reimer. Vanessa Elaine Rizzo. Garrett K. Robbins. Eric Rodriguez. Isabella J. Rodriguez. Jesus J. Rodriguez. Valeria Rodriguez. Glenn Romanick. Isaiah Romero Aviles.
Andrew Ryan Rosado. Lisa Trinidad Rosales Garnica. Marley Rouse. Lauren Elizabeth Rudin. Kara Mary Ryan. Nathan Frank Riza. Elizabeth Marie Salazar. Jitzari Salazar. Juan Alexi Salazar. Ryan Patrick Salazar. Julie Sandria. Logan J. Scharf. Hunter Nicole Shadel. Jameson C. Shoemaker. Jake Robert Semro. Caitlin Serafino. Zachary Joseph Sessler. Cameron Michael Severino. Peyton Schaefer. Benjamin David Simon. Connor James Sketch. Savannah A. Skenendor. Nicholas George Slavikov. Kate Marie Smingy. Keegan Katie Smith. Kelsey Joy Smith. Tyler Jacob Smith. Ian Foster Solak. Noah Anthony Solis. Carter Gene Spoden. Claire Riley Stewart. Carly Lynn Stone. Salvatore Scott Stork. Mairead Barbara Stotes. Brian Robert Stripp. Destiny Hope Stroner. Tyler C. Stumo. Christina Marie Chagru. Emily Christine Solikowski. Maya Lucia Swick. Dylan Szczepański. Jacob Szczepański. Noelle Natalie Szczepański. Daphne Tapia. Christian Carlos Tepetla. Jenna Renee Thompson. Christian Jacob Tintera. Henry Michael Tipton. Olivia Elise Tote. Christina Toniolo. Lucas Daniel Traer. Jacob E. Trinidad. Chloe Ann Traub. Jacob E. Tubb. Stephanie May Varkados. Samantha Alexis Vadimo. Joshua William Velasquez. Wilmina Amy Vogley. Nicholas Ryan Volmert. Zachary Walper. Joseph Robert Walsh. Justin M. Washington. Shay Yoon Watkins. Thomas Mitchell Watson. Addison Blair Weeks. Brady C. Widener. Shane Andrew Wershing. Cole Allen Thomas White. Daniel R. Wiebmer. Abigail Grace Wiegand. Julie Faith Wilgos. Elise M. Weiss. Sarah Janet Wilcox. Alexandria Mackenzie Wilson. Brandon John Wilson. Tyler James Winters. Lily Marie Louise Wiesness. Brandon Robert Wittig. Raymond Brad Wolski. Macy Catherine Woodlock. Elena Myung Woltz. John Bauer Ruck. Julia Zidane. Samantha Christina Zimmerman. Carson George Zorza. Would the class of 2019 please rise? It is now time to turn your tassel to signify your official graduation from Crystal Lake South High School.
You can go ahead and be seated. Our final speaker for the day has participated as a member of the Gator football and Gator wrestling team. He has also spent the last 2 years working at Urban Air here in Crystal Lake, where he is currently a manager. This individual also works for DeMolay International, a youth leadership organization where he is currently the state senior counselor and the winner of the DeMolay of the Year Award. When I asked Mrs. Hatfield about this young man, she explained, Noah Laney is an intelligent young man with a love for history and a natural talent for writing. I always enjoyed reading his work in AP language and composition, and I was excited to learn that he is planning to study English, political science, and law at Northern Illinois University. She stated, what I find most admirable about Noah is his character. His optimism and perseverance in response to setbacks is truly inspiring. I will always remember the photo memoir he read aloud to his peers. detailing personal struggles he had recently overcome. She sat in awe of Noah's ability to be honest and vulnerable as he shared his journey towards self-acceptance. Towards the end of the memoir, Noah wrote, "No matter what your struggles, no matter what struggles you face in life, to face them alone is to ignore the support that is always surrounding you. Don't be afraid to be open. Don't be afraid to share how you feel." Noah has proven to be a strong leader through both his words and his actions, and I am so proud of him for that. Please welcome Noah Laney to the stage for the Class of 2019 farewell speech.
My time in high school were some of the worst years of my life. Now that I've brought down everyone's mood, please allow me to explain myself. I cannot stand up here and lie to you. In these last 4 years, I faced more tribulations than I ever thought I would, and I cried way more than I like to admit. There is something in my eyes, I swear. During my lowest point, at the end of my junior year, injuries forced me to walk away from the two sports I loved, and less dramatically than I envisioned it in my own mind, left me without an identity as I did so. For the first time in my life, I didn't know what to call myself, who I was, and what my goals were. It was a time of solitude, it was a time of regret, and it was a time of despondency. I know I am not the only student who has felt or even still feels this way. In the course of our lives, we are all bound to come upon hard times. To struggle is to be human, and no one sitting before me is out of the reach of humanity. There is quite possibly nothing that connects us more than this common burden. What's even more exciting is that, truth be told, the worst is yet to come. After high school, many of us are going to college, attending a trade school, enlisting in the military, or even already starting a career. We would be unwise to not assume that in the course of our future lives, with as many years as we have left to live, the reality of growing into adulthood is that there will be times of crushing hardships. High school, my friends, was only the beginning. At this point, I would like to reassure you that, as I'm sure you were hoping, my message is not so disheartening or negative as to end right there. No. Truth be told, I've been withholding another fact from all of you. That fact is that high school was, despite what I've previously stated, four of the most fun and uplifting years of my life. Making such a claim now, when the entirety of the speech thus far has been wholly negative, might seem preposterous. So I'll ask once again, please allow me to explain myself. For every low point I have faced, there was an equally influential moment of growth and positivity in my life. For every tribulation, there was a group of people who cared for me, be it parents or teachers, and were willing to problem solve with me and correct my path towards success moving forwards. For every tear that I spilled, there was a friend to grasp me by the hand and help me wipe away those tears, and replace them instead with a smile or laughter. I could not envision myself as I am now without the influence of all the events that transpired in my life these last 4 years, good or bad, because through them, I grew as a person, as a friend, and as a leader. Class of 2019, wherever you may find yourself in your life, no matter how low or dire your situation might be, always believe that you have the ability inside you to overcome. Always remember that there are people who care about you and are willing to walk with you in your time of struggle. Our futures are not meant to be easy, and just as we, as human beings, are destined to face the rough realities of what life has in store for us, we are all also equipped with the same ability to take every challenge as an experience of growth, to overcome it and become a greater person at the end. The people graduating in this class hold the potential to change and influence our world for the better. So no matter what, hold your head up high, stand firm and proud, and always remember that you hold within you the power to turn what may be the worst years of your life into the very best.
One more round of applause for Noah. All right, students, let's go ahead and stand one more time. Remember, as you walk off campus today, please don't be a stranger. Remember, once a Gator, always a Gator. By the power vested in me by the Board of Education and Community High School District 155, I now declare the class of 2019 as graduates of Crystal Lake South High School. Let's hear one more time for these students.